OpenStreetMap kind of shows some trails. I set out south of Santiago in search of the smallest trails and the tallest mountains.
Yo hace videos y sale a YouTube.
Ah, pasa. Es de la hormiga. Imagínense, mire por dónde bajó con esto, con la hormiga.
After 10 days, I was still going. Low on food and through impossible grades and sandy mountain passes. Somewhere between the howling wind and the vast emptiness ahead.
Y una mula, la mamá caballo, la papá burro.
Claro.
¿Y mamá burro, papá caballo no se puede?
Nunca se ha hecho.
Ah.
¿Cómo te pregunta? But what is the thing you like the most about the mountains here?
There's no people. The geography, muy bonito. Obviously, and there's no people. La pureza, la naturaleza. Cristina.
Digamos, él vive en Nueva York, yo vivo en Santiago, full of people, full of cars.
Algo muy distinto que me gusta esto. Que obviamente tú no lo compartes, la camaradería. Me gusta armar los viajes, organizar. Me gusta mucho hacer las rutas, los planos, diseñar los trayectos. Todo eso me gusta.
I wanted to see how my new friends get ready and arm all the mules for the 2-day trek out of here. I had to keep going, step by step by step, into the sand and rock-covered lava flows, like a little ant on a never-ending journey. In 1932, Vulcan Kizapo erupted, releasing 9 cubic kilometers of lava, ash columns up to 30 kilometers into the air, and spreading sand and ash for over 800 kilometers into Chile and Argentina, and changing the surrounding valleys into the surreal landscape that it is today. Hard to describe and impossible to photograph. Thank you. hard to learn when I gave myself over to it. Learned every step and my efforts were met when it rang and it told and it sang. Rattle on strings, familiar rings. If the line is a chain past an ink, then each fiddler that played is another that stayed to turn himself into a link. And he's still up here somewhere, I think. And I hear the old voices sing.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have some good news. What we have in front of us, it may appear like a dream, or perhaps a figment of the imagination, but this is indeed a road with tire tracks.
We're like of two, to a small, je ne sais pas. We're le futur, to a small. Je ne sais pas, enfermé dans la glace et Dieu sur le gil. J'entends à peine le battement de son cœur. Il est là sous la neige, je l'espère. Où est l'histoire? Où sont les souvenirs? Où se trouve le langage que je connais? Est-il sur les gives, si léger est le battement sans cœur? Il est là sous la neige, je l'espère. Et j'entends les voix anciennes chanter cette chanson.
Taking a break from the mountains, a friend suggested I should check out the beach. So we are going to the beach in Chile. But anyway, this has been the most relaxing ride so far. I mean, it's not super smooth and I'm just moving slowly. There's different train stations and good shade. The only thing is there's these giant goat heads. And there, okay, so there's one. Let's take them all out. There's two. This one is too deep. I'm just gonna leave this one. There's three, four, five, six. Ooh, that's so crisp. Seven, eight. You know, like every now and then comes the moment and I'm like, wait, I didn't have to push my bike today. I didn't have to lift it. Well, I had to lift it over a few fences, but I didn't have to go up mountain passes. And, you know, I almost rode everything. And I'm like, hey, that's what bikepacking is like.
Thank you.
betting on the city of New Orleans. Illinois Central, Monday morning race. 15 cars and 15 restless riders. 3 conductors and 25 sacks of maize. Out on the southbound Odyssey, the train pulls out of Kankakee and it rolls past houses and farms and fields. Passing towns that have no name and freight yards full of old black men and the graveyards of the rusted automobiles. Just a singing good morning, American, how are you? Don't you know me, I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. And I was dealing cards with the old men in the club car. Penny a point, ain't nobody keeping score. Pass that paper bag that holds that bottle. Feel the wheels grumbling beneath the floor. Sons of Pullman porters and the sons of engineers ride their daddy's magic carpet made of steam. And mothers with the babes asleep go rocking to the gentle beat, and the rhythm of the rails is all they dream. Just a singing good morning, American, how are you? Don't you know me, I'm your native son. I'm the train they call the city of New Orleans. And I'll be gone 500 miles when the day is done. I'm on the city of New Orleans, changing cars in Memphis, Tennessee. Halfway home and we'll be there by morning. Through the Mississippi dark.
Not the most fun situation, as you can see. It's about a four or five story height and then down to the river. I'm just hopping on these wooden things, and they all look okay, and the bike is balanced on the rail track, kind of like Danny McCaskill, but less epic. Like, I don't have a fear of heights or something, but I don't think you need to have a fear of heights to be uncomfortable walking on this stuff.
I reached the Pacific coast for the first time in South America on a rainy day, with big expectations of crashing waves and endless coastlines. But instead, I walked right into this disturbing landscape that the Chilean forest industry creates. Plantations upon plantations, mills and logging trucks covering the coast. The coast highway seemed like a dirty industrial park stretching on for miles, devoid of natural vegetation and with the sound of chainsaws buzzing in the distance. But there were nicer stretches, with towns and beaches and lighthouses, where the chubby coastal dogs rest in the shade and the hungry cyclist can find some decent food. Camping was easy and almost always with a good view and amazing sunset. The easy life on the coast was nice, but it wasn't enough. There was no excitement keeping up at night or wondering where the trail may lead. No endless mountain valleys and imposing mountain peaks. I made my way to Chian, where I had sent my boat, and once again began dreaming of the beauty and the solitude of the Andes.
Look at that guy. Hola, amigo. Hey, friend. You're a bit wild, eh?
Río Itata.
Itata.
Itata, río Itata. Cisne. Cisne de cuello negro.
Uh-huh.
Hay muy poco en Chile, muy poco.
Ah, esto sabes.
Sí, sabe, cisne de cuello negro.
¿Llega en la mesa del gato?
Sí, sí.
Está amigable. Hay unos que te pelea, que sí. No...
Este es cachorro. ¡Cachorra! Mira, está bonita, ¿eh?
Sí, hermoso. Claro.
¿Y esta es vegetación nativa?
Mm-hmm. Todo esto es tan nativo. Raro. ¿Y por allá no?
No, por allá no.
Pero el nativo es... el eucalipto allá no.
No, el eucalipto es australiano.
Ajá, también.
De Australia.
Ajá.
Sí.
Pero esos se
pinos,
utiliza...
Esos pinos... Mm-hmm. Son de California.
¿Sí?
Sí. Ah. De California.
Pero puro pino.
Puro pino, sí. Pino. Pino, allá.
¿Y tú qué pareces para toda la... Bueno, es como una gran plantación.
Sí, eso se ocupa para madera, para mm-hmm. construcción de casa.
Pero piensas, ¿es una cosa que es necesaria para el trabajo y todo?
Gusta. O sea, sí, mucho trabajo.
Porque se ve que hay oposición en algunos pueblos.
Sí, pero el problema es que ya está la ley... hecha para que la gente o los agricultores planten pino. Uh-huh. Porque la ley se los permite y los ayuda económicamente. Uh-huh. Pero ha sido un deterioro considerable para las especies nativas chilenas.
Claro.
Porque se ha exterminado mucho el bosque nativo. Uh-huh.
Muchas gracias. Salud. Salud.
Bienvenido por tu paso por Chile. Que lo disfrutes.
Gracias.
Esta es la región de Ñuble.
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 Ñuble. Salud.
Salud.
Como eres blanca, ojos de diosa, la más hermosa que yo besé. En Río Grande hay un paraíso y hay una fruta que conocí. Hay un santuario de perlas finas, las que quisiera ponerte a ti. Lloran las flores y las estrellas pueden brillar. Hasta la luna pierde sus luces, por eso siempre te he de adorar. Pues yo quisiera que al contemplarte, rosa fragante, linda y sensual, eres la diosa de los jardines y de las flores de todo el mar.
¡Buen día!
It was hard to try and capture the hospitality of the Chilean people. I spent a few days with Matt before the railroad, and Alejandro invited me to visit Chian. The owners of a small cabin resort invited me to stay, and I made final preparations for the road ahead.
Hey. I guess he didn't like being on camera. Whoa. That was a big reaction. It's like, hey dude, I don't want to be on YouTube.
So we're here in the Valley of Atacalco, and another stretch that might not be as populated as I initially thought. So I've got the boat on the bike, which makes things a little heavy. But the first few days, it should be easy. I've got a road to the end of the Valley of Atacalco. And then this next song, Patricio Mann's Arriba en la Cordillera, he actually sings about the Valley of Atacalco and the Pass of Atacalco. And I'm like, you can't get more loco than that. Like, this is the valley.
Mm-hmm. ¿Qué sabes de cordilleras? Si tú naciste tan lejos, hay que conocer la piedra que corona el ventisquero. Hay que recorrer callando los atajos del silencio y cortar por las orillas de los lagos cumbres. Mi padre anduvo su vida por entre piedras y cerros. La viuda blanca en su grupa, la maldición del arriero, llevó mi viejo esa noche a robar el ganado ajeno junto al paso de atacar a la entrada del invierno. Le preguntaron a golpes y él respondió con silencios. Los guardias cordilleranos clavaron su cruz al viento. Los Ángeles Santa Fe fueron nombres del infierno. Hasta mi casa llegaba la ley buscando al cuatrero. Mi madre escondió la cara cuando el lobo vio del cerro. Y arriba en la cordillera la noche entraba en sus huesos. El que fue tan hombre y sol llevó la muerte en su arreo. Nosotros cruzamos hoy con un rebaño del bueno. Arriba en la cordillera no nos vio cruzar ni el viento. Con qué orgullo de quien ríe.
Wow, that's a proper mountain. Holy crap. So the time has come to inflate our boats and venture into the water. I hope it still floats. It's been a while since I've floated on it. That's pretty much it. Physically demanding. The user of this product should understand that participating in packrafting may involve serious injury or death. You're responsible for your own actions and decisions. The fabric used to manufacture these rafts is selected with lightweight and packability being the most important factor. Because of this lightness of the fabric, the raft is easily punctured, and this must be always a main factor in your judgment. You're responsible for not overloading the boat or using it in situations that you cannot control your safety. Do not float in any river that you're not prepared to swim. A punctured tube will result in an immediate immersion in the water, and you must be prepared to deal with the resulting danger. Alpaca Raft makes no claims to the durability of our product or to the type of water that the boat can handle.
said your captain, I stole me below. Hold me amongst all your cards. Oh, we were sea-bound and aimless at best, clutching that she was just a gambler at heart.
Él está lejos.
Estamos preocupados, weón, que no salía y loco.
Ay, que pensé que moría en un momento,
sí. Sí, él está bien.
Pero sentía que moría en un momento, digo.
Sí.
Thank you.
Aprende el moto.
It all worked out at the end, and my new friends were safe. But if the wind did not ease, he would not have made it back. The solitude and the beauty of the mountains comes at a price. One should always respect Mother Nature. It was not too long ago, on this very shore, that a group of soldiers was ordered to travel in a winter storm from the nearby military base. The weather turned even worse and it was a complete whiteout, where the soldiers got separated and fell one by one. And on this day, there is a tall monument casting a dark shadow. 45 holes shine inside the darkness. One for each soldier that was lost in the storm.
So there is a slight hiccup with the Chilean police here, because we're so close to Argentina. They have a border post just down the road, like in 4 kilometers. But the thing is that even though I'm not going to Argentina, they won't let me pass without stamping out, without exiting the country officially. So that's a bit of a problem, because I'm not going to Argentina. So instead I'm just gonna go down, looks like a road. There's just a little river down there, and then I can come around the hill and join the road on the other side. So that's the plan. Hopefully there won't be too deep of a river or anything.
I think these cows, they're trying to follow me. And they're giving away my position because they're picking up so much dust. And there's the police station over there.
He wants to be an alpinist. Do you know that here in the Andes
There's no alpinism, but there is Andeism, because alpinist is from the Alps, and here there's no Alps, and we've got Andeism.
Didn't matter how slow I went or what obstacles lay ahead, I knew that every once in a while I would get to ride my bike. And after all, that is what bikes are made for.
Hola, buen día.
Buenos días.
Muy dura la bajada.
Sí. Pásalo.
¿Y aquí cerca de Trapa Trapa?
Sí, aquí, por este, Trapa Trapa.
Hola.
Hola. ¿Qué vino allá?
Yo vine de allá, de Laguna Laja.
¿Allá?
Sí, antes de Chillán.
¿Antes de Chillán?
Sí.
Oh.
Aquí en Trapa Trapa hay una tienda, kiosco.
¿Kiosco?
Sí, para comida o...
Sí, ahí tengo, ahí, al lado del camino, ahí mismo.
¿Con letrero?
Sí, con letrero ahí.
Ah, bueno.
Ahí de todo, ahí, galleta, pero...
Ah, perfecto. ¿Y se puede encontrar internet en la escuela o...?
¿En la escuela?
Sí, hay, sí, un wifi.
En la escuela allí. Allí, ¿no queda hasta casa allí?
Ajá.
Sí, ahí, en el puerto, poquito allá.
Ah, perfecto, gracias.
Sí, hay una escuela. Ahí pasa el tema al frente ahí, ¿no? Allí se ve la casa.
Uh-huh.
Hay un letrero ahí. Ahí al lado también, todo.
Gracias.
Ya.
¿Y sus chivos son arriba?
Ya, arriba.
¿Son suyos?
Sí.
Ah, pero corre rápido.
Sí, pues.
señor, yo grabo un poquito de video, ¿está bien?
Sí, está bien.
Bueno, buen ya. día.
Chao. Ahí está el negocio.
¿Allá?
Sí, al lado del camino.
Road. My good dog friend helping me get rid of some tortillas, which I packed too many of, and there should be a store later today. He's eating them like it's bread, you know?
Hey, buddy.
How are ya? He came with two other dogs. They were just wandering the forests. I was up here on the hills of this valley and they came by. This was the one that kind of sticked around. Right, bud? It's a bit of conditioning. Be friendly to human. Collect reward. Yeah, there's three more. You got them? Hey, pig, you wanna eat some noodles? Yeah, fleas. I know you have fleas, don't ya? Yeah, fleas. Hey, no entering the tent, okay? No. Hey. No. Hey, no entering the tent. It's one person tent. You can't go inside. No dogs allowed. Hey, friend, it's a one person tent. One person, not one person and one dog, just one person. Morning, buddy.
Just like how I couldn't judge my fat bike by its ability to float, I wanted to see how the boat handles just by itself. So I set out to learn some river rafting, and like it is in Chile, it didn't take too long to meet some kayakers who invited me for a float.
¿Dentro de tu mochila es seca?
¿Esa?
Sí.
Y hay una otra seca y después una bolsa.
Ah, ok. Por si te da fuerte. Sí.
Pero aquí tampoco.
¿Ah?
Pero aquí tampoco. También es posible.
Hola. Hay dos rápidos que puede que, si no tomas una buena línea, pero yo te puedo indicar, anda por allá.
Ah, perfecto, perfecto. No, porque si algo te pasa, tú puedes nadar más rápido con tu remo, ajá, solo. O el remo puede trancarse.
No estoy afuera del bote.
Exacto.
Con el remo.
Por eso nosotros nunca tenemos el remo amarrado, porque yo me doy vuelta, giro, ajá, salgo y nado con mi remo.
Para
alcanzar al bote. O si algo pasa y el remo queda atascado, va a quedar el bote y el remo.
Entonces mejor que lo saco. Mm.
Una es hacer lo mismo que hicieron los chicos.
Ajá.
O la otra es reventar una ola y cruzamos hacia la izquierda, la que tú quieras. ¿O prefieres la más fácil?
¿Piensas que puedo hacerlo difícil?
Si algo pasa, te rescato.
Vamos.
Look at all these brownies. I'm just passing by. Creatures of the forest, assemble! Keep calm and carry on.
The chubby cows led me through the dust further up to yet another volcano, away from the pine plantations and toward the trees that grow here. Some looked old, and others might have been here for thousands of years. But this may as well have been the same dust that killed the dinosaurs, and it was everywhere. And being here on a weekend was a bad timing. And as I was toting my bike along this dusty volcano road, along came a buggy, and well, you know the rest.
I was toting my pack along the dusty Winnemucca road, when along came a semi with a high end canvas covered load. If you're going to Winnemucca Mac with me, you can ride. And so I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texas, County, Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Tallapoosa, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Oskaloosa, Tennessee, Chicopee, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake, Devil's Lake, Crater Lake, Beach Lake. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Louisville, Nashville, Knoxville, Ombabaka, Shepherdville, Jacksonville, Waterville, Coast, Rocket, Pittsfield, Springfield, Bakersfield, Shreveport, Hackensack, Cadillac, Fond du Lac, Davenport, Idaho, Jellicoe, Argentina, Diamantina, Pasadena, Catalina, see what I mean. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Pittsburgh, Parkersburg, Gravelburg, Colorado, Ellensburg, Rexburg, Vicksburg, Eldorado, Larimore, Atmore, Havistraw, Chattanooga, Chaska, Nebraska, Alaska, Opelika, Baraboo, Waterloo, Kalamazoo, Kansas City, Sioux City, Cedar City, Dodge City, what a pity. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been everywhere.
Some time ago, Pedro wrote to invite me at his mountain lodge, and as it worked out, I was passing by the same valley. So I went from eating pasta and oatmeal to amazing chef meals and the best shower in South America. It had been a long time since I went hiking, and I really wondered how it compared to biking. And after some typical Chilean bureaucracy, I was good to go. Gone was the clinking and clanking, and I could stop and enjoy the silence and the sunlight. Old little creatures that would otherwise run away would hang out just for a little longer. Step by step, I continue onto a sort of a trance, an escape from everything. And it didn't matter where I was going, for as long as I was going.
I also want to thank all of you for helping me do this. It's really amazing that I can, you know, do this and stop every once in a while and make videos and put them on YouTube and hey, then keep going. So that's really awesome, and I'm very happy to be doing this and very happy to have so many people from all over the world helping me see the world.
Thank you.
I'm no food buddy. Yeah. Ow, hey, don't, no biting. No licking and no biting. Okay, my friend? You're a big horse. Oh, don't lick me. He probably like all the sweat, eh? They give me some salt, human. Yeah. Hello, hello. Hey. Look, your friend's coming. Easy. Dear friend number two. So I want to say, I totally didn't see that coming, but I had it coming. Oh, it's falling. Okay, I think it fell. It fell down to the ground. So there won't be any tree climbing today. But the drone is somewhere up there. Thank you.